Welcome to Arvind Singh Academy. You are watching our YouTube channel and we are discussing quadratic equation. This is another session of quadratic equation and hopefully you have watched all the previous lectures from part 1 to part 7 before watching this part 8. This is the 8th lecture in the series and before watching all the previous lectures you should not watch part 8. This is what's suggested. Now we are going to discuss some more questions what we have discussed in the previous lecture, some more questions related to quadratic formula so that you will be familiar and it will have a good practice to analyze and evaluate the questions related to quadratic equation. So hopefully you are enjoying this topic, isn't it? Yes, sir? Yeah, I hope you are enjoying this topic, I know that. So let me write few questions today. First question I am writing here, a very simple one. Just to warm up, in every big match, players have warm up. So here you have warm up session. First question, just I am giving for warm up. What you have learned in the previous lecture, you just recall that, and thereafter we will give some good questions when you will warm. So solve this question. This is the solution. It is given here. Solve question. Solve this question. Every time the question written like this. You have to solve this, means find the value of x, nothing else. So let me write here the first question solution. We can first make this in quadratic form. Although this is not in quadratic form, so how you can nail this? So we can take the LCM x minus 4 and x minus 7. And LCM will be x minus 7 plus x minus 4 is equal to 11 by 30. So that can be written as further 2x minus 11 divided by x square minus 11x plus 28 is equal to 11 upon 30. Again I can write this, 30 will come this side. 60x minus 330 is equal to 11x square. 11 and 11 is 120, 1x plus 280 plus 28 is equal to 308, like this, and that will be coming. How to multiply with 11? 11x square and that 11, 11 ja 121x and 28 into 11 means 28 into 10, that is 280, because multiplying by 10 is very easy, na? So 28 multiply by 10 is 280 and then I add 28, 280 plus 28 is 308. So this is a quicker way to multiply. Simultaneously we will discuss all those tricks as well. So 11x square, that will come finally, 11x square, 60 will come this side, it will be also negative, 181x, and this will come positive, this side. So what will happen? 638 is equal to 0. That is a question, very weak question. It is almost difficult to find the factor of these numbers, and it will be very tough. So what to do? We can go with the quadratic formula. Even using quadratic formula will also be a difficult situation, but we can do that. How to deal with such questions? If I can make the factor, it is also possible. But let us, I want to use quadratic formula. What is A here? 11. B is what? 181 with negative sign. And C is what? 638. And we have to calculate D. And what is D? B square minus 4AC, that is minus 181 whole square minus 4 into 11 into 638, that may come, right? 11 into this 11 and this is 4 into 11 into 638. 181 whole square, let me write 181 whole square, what will come? 181 whole square, let me write for you people like this, otherwise I have a trick in which I can do that. 8 1 ja 8, 8 8 ja 64, 6 8 1 ja 8 and 6 14, and then if you multiply with this, this is 181. So finally 1 8 8 16, 4 2 6 1 7 and 8 4 12, 2 carry 1 and 2 plus 1 3. So this is 32761. Just I am dealing with what you are getting. So this is 700. D will come like, this is the calculation part. So D will come like 32761 minus 11 multiplied by 44. This is 8 4 is 32. 32 2 and this is 4 3 is 12 and 2 14 and carry 1. 6 4 is 24 and 1 25. Multiply by 11, so this will be 2 5 4 2. So 2 6 9 and 7 and 2. So 27 7 9 62. 2 7 9 62 will come. And what is that? 11 minus 2 is 9. 15 minus 5 minus 15 minus 6 is 9 again. And what is left here? 6. That is 16 minus 7 is 9 again. And what is left there? This is 1. 1 minus 2. So again, 11 minus 2 is 9. So 9, 9, 9, 9 will left. Right? 11 minus 2 is 9. And 15 minus 6 is 9. 16 minus 9 is, let me write once again, 11 minus 2 is 9. And this is 5. So 15 minus 6 is 9. Now 6 is left. 16. 16 minus 9 is 7. Sorry. 16 minus 9 is 7. Right? 6 comes. So 16 minus 9 is 7. And there 1 left again. So this is 31 minus 27 is 4. So 4, 7, 9, 9 that is left. 4, 7, 9, 9 is left. And now we have to find the value of x. So x is nothing else but minus b plus minus root under d by 2a. So I can write here minus of minus 181 plus minus root under 4, 7, 9, 9. What is the square root of 4, 7, 9, 9? 2 into, what is a? A is 11. So I can write 181 plus minus, this is 22. And this is the square root of 47998. Nothing else, but we can see here 6 is here 36. For you people, I am just calculating this. This is 11 and 99 again will come. This is 12. If I put 9, so 997, then or 7, and what will happen if multiply with 7? 7 7 is 49. So 9 carry 4 and 12 7 is 84. No, this is not like that. Something in decimals will come. 4 7 7 is 49. That is not possible. 6 6 is 36. 1 1 9 9. This is 12. If I put 8 here or even 9, 9 then 8, then what will happen? 8 8 is 8 8 is 64, that is 4, carry 5, and 6, 8 8 is 64, 4, carry 6, 12 8 is 96, and 6, 102. So even 9 is also possible. 9 is it 9 possible? 9 9 is 9 9 is 81, 8, 12 9 is 108, and 108 and 8, 116. So that will left 8. And 3, 38, cancel. So this is 9, 9, 18, 12 plus 1 is something big will come. Something 12 plus 1 is 13. So 13 points something will come. If I put decimals here, because I have put first 6 and then 9, and thereafter some decimals value has been, if I put decimals, 2 0 will come, and that will be, if I put 1 0, then that will come 3 times approx. So almost 3 times approximately. So 69.28 approx that will come. 2 and 8, 3 will not come accurately. 28, and this is what? 181 plus 69.28 upon 22, and other factor will come 181 minus 69.28 divided by 22. So this is the way you will be able to calculate this, and that will be the answer of this question. So this type of question, maybe some this can come right in terms of factor as well. If you don't want to write in terms of decimals, then you can write in terms of factors as well. 9, 9, 18, 18 plus 7, 25 plus 4, 29. That is not approximately in which you can find the factors. It will be difficult to find the factors, but you can deal with this. If I divide by 11, 11, 4 is 44. 3 will left, 39, 11, 3 is 33, and 6, 69, so again it will be not a factor. So it is very difficult to find the factors. but you will be able to answer these questions by using this. So what I mean to say with this question, what is the message I want to convey to you, that whatever the question is given, you have to make first important form like this. This is the type of quadratic equation. After that, you can deal with the question of why it would be very difficult, right? So this is the situation where you can deal with. And first, you have to go for quadratic equation, and thereafter, you can solve it by using the quadratic formula. So we will discuss today only those kind of questions where this they are not actually given in quadratic form, but we have to transform them in quadratic equation. Hopefully you got this, and let me write some of the questions. My basic purpose to deal with such questions is just to tell you that what is going to happen. And because question is written randomly without taking proper care of data, it is written by me only directly without taking proper care of data. Might be some proper data is not set up, and that is why answers will come in different form. But believe me, the nature of the question is same. When whatever the data may be, you should know the concept only. Concept is good, then for any data you can solve the question. Data is not the material thing. What is the material thing? It's concept only. So if you have concept, you know how to deal with the question, you know how to convert the questions in quadratic form, and thereafter how to use this quadratic formula, you can solve any question. Data is not a material thing at all. So let me write some other question. Another question I am writing here, question number 2 today. That is 3x minus 4 by 7 plus 7 upon 3x minus 4 is equal to 5 by 2. What question I am writing? Might be possible that some questions may tally with some books and some study materials as well. Whatever you have for books, it doesn't mean I have taken the question from there. It is a question which usually students ask, and whenever students ask question to me, somehow the question came in my mind and it is just stored in long-term memory. So questions, some of the questions what I am telling may tally with some books, right? But most of the questions will not tally at all, because it has been generated and framed in at any that instant of time and delivered to you. So it will be good for you as well, just a mental exercise. I don't like to take a book and read the questions and then explain it. I want to generate myself so that it comes in directly from the mind, and it will have a good mental exercise for you as well. So what to do? Let me write this question. This is a question. How to deal with this? If I can write this, taking LCM, 3x minus 4 whole square, because LCM is this, plus 7 square divided by 7 into 3x minus 4 is equal to 5 by 2, right? So that can be written as further, 9x square, 4 3 is 12, 12 2 is 24x plus 16 plus 49 divided by 7 3 is 21x plus 7 4 is 20 minus 28, right? And this is 5 by 2. Again I can multiply by 2, so 2 into 9x x square minus 24x plus this is 65, and here 5 into 21x minus 28. Now I can write this 18x square minus 48x plus 130 is equal to 105x minus 140. Big data, don't worry about that. It is just a calculation, and that is also a part of training, that you should not be frustrated with the big numbers, because in quadratic equation, what all you need to learn is patience. Once you have patience of dealing the data, you can solve any question. But if you don't have patience, you are not able to solve the questions, even small questions. You will be frustrated. So that is why I am taking here big data, so that you will learn about how to handle the pressure and how to handle the data as well. So here what will come? Let me explain this. 18x square, this will come this side, and this will be also negative. So 48 minus 105 is 153x, and that will come this side, this will be 270 is equal to 0. Do you think it will be cancelled by 18? It will be cancelled by 9. So 9 can cancel 2x square. 9 1 ja 9 and 9 7 ja 63. So 17x plus 9 3 ja 37 is equal to 0. 30 into 2 is 60. 30 into 2 is 60 and 20 into 3 is also 60. So we can write here 2x square minus 20x plus 3x plus 30 is equal to 0. So if I take 2x common, what is left here? X minus 10. If I took 3 common, x, this is plus 30. 30 into 2 is 60. So 60, that can be not 20 minus, because this product would be negative, so that would be wrong. Here the product is positive, so and the product of these two is negative. I haven't taken care of this sign, and therefore this will be wrong. That cannot be right the factor. We can have factors of two negative terms, so that their product would be positive. Do we have any two products, negative terms with product is 60? Two integral numbers lesser than 17? Can you have? We can find the factors that 60 can be written as 15 into 2, 15 into 4, 10 into 6, 30 into 2, 6 into 10, so any other 12 into 5, that is also 60, right? Like that. But do you have some 6 17? Yes, 12 plus 5 is 17. So we can have two factors. That is 2x square minus 12x minus 5x plus 30 is equal to 0. So that would be factor, because the product of 12 minus 12 and minus 5 would be plus 16. So remember this fact. What the basic concept I have told you, you must remember all those basic concepts so that it should not be any mistake. Most of the times the student has written what I have written previously, and they are not able to find the answers. They have not taken care of the sign, and that is why there is a mistake. So proper sign should be taken, and thereafter you will be able to get the right answer. If I took 2x common from this, what is left? X. 2x has been taken, so out of 12, 2 has been taken common, what is left? 6. And x has been taken common. Here if I took 5 common, x minus 6. Why sign inside that will change? Because of negative sign has been taken common, so inside the bracket sign will change. Now if I took x minus 6 common from this two, what is left? 2x minus 5 is equal to 0. X minus 6 is equal to 0, or 2x minus 5 is equal to 0. So either x is equal to 6 or x is equal to 5 by 2. So solution set is 6 and 5 by 2. This is the solution set, and that is the answer of this question. Hopefully you got this. First, what we have to do, we have to form a general quadratic equation. After seeing this question, after simplification, this is a quadratic equation what we want to find, and that is in simplest form. So once you've got the quadratic equation, solving question is not difficult problems now, but deriving the questions in quadratic form, that really do. So you need to do that. And first, if you will derive all those equations in quadratic form, thereafter you will be able to solve it. Hopefully you are doing this now and you are getting this. How to deal with such situation? Okay, let me write some question, more question. So question is, now the question is, here let me write some easy one. That is 2x upon x minus 3 plus 1 upon 2x plus 3 is equal to 3x plus 9 upon x minus 3x, or is equal to 0. Let me write like this. This is the question. I can write here. Or even it can be written like this, 2x plus 3 and this is 0. Or maybe we can write like this also. Some more difficult question I am going to frame this. X minus 3 and 2x plus 3. Can I write like this? This is the question. Makes the sign plus here, and that is equal to 0. Now, this looks very big question, right? It looks very big one, and it looks difficult too. If I write a plus sign, then it will be comparatively easier. Why is so? Let me write first this is equal to, otherwise it will be my quadratic equation, which seems to be very difficult for you right now. Although we will solve some questions in my quadratic form, but here the question says a quadratic form right now. It is not a biquadratic equation. So I can deal with taking the LCM 2x into 2x plus 3, that is 2x into 2x plus 3 plus x minus 3 whole divided by x minus 3 and 2x plus 3. Here in this question, some non-negative restrictions have been must be given in the question that x should not be equal to 3 or minus 3 by 2. This is two negative restrictions. Non-negative restrictions, non-zero restrictions have been given. Non-zero means that cannot be zero. Denominator cannot be zero. Otherwise, it would be infinity. And now, here also 3x plus 9 upon x minus 3 and 2x plus 3. So, that can be written as 4x square plus 6x plus x minus 3 divided by x minus 3 and 2x plus 3, right? That is 3x plus 9 upon x minus 3 and 2x plus 3 as well. If I multiply this whole scenario by this way, so what will come? 4x square plus 7x minus 3, and because this is not equal to 0, so both terms can be cancelled out. We can divide by non-zero items, both the sides. Even we can take common, and thereafter we can put it equal to 0, that is also possible. But because these are non-zero items, and that will not give the value of x, so there is no loss of root as well. We can cancel both the sides. So this is 3x plus 9. Now what will come? 4x square plus 7x minus 3 minus 3x minus 9 is equal to 0. And therefore this will come like 4x square plus 4x minus 12 is equal to 0. X square plus x minus 3 is equal to 0. And further, x square minus plus x minus 3 is equal to 0, because 7x minus 3x is 4x, and minus 3 minus 9 is minus 12. In that case, a is equal to 1, b is equal to 1, and c is equal to minus 3. So what will be d? B square minus 4ac, 1 square minus 4 into 1 into minus 3, that is 1 plus 12, which is 13. And now value of x can be determined as minus b plus minus root d by 2a, that is minus 1 plus minus root 13 upon 2 into 1. So two answers came, one minus 2 plus root 13 by 2, another minus 1 minus root 13 by 2, and these are the answer of the questions. These are the two answers which can be derived. I hope you got it. First you have to transform this question, and thereafter you have to proceed. Because this is not equal to 0, x by x is not equal to 3, x is not equal to minus 3 by 2, so these are two non-zero quantity, and we can divide by non-zero quantity both the sides, right? So that is why I have divided it. Got the point? Okay. Now, let us see some other question. Question number 5. Question number 5. Let us try here. 9x square minus 9a plus b into x plus 2a square plus 5ab plus 2b square is equal to 0. Like that. This is the question. Looks very big, you know. Looks very big one. That is a, b and c. What to do and how to solve this question? 2a square plus 5ab plus 2b square, that is c here, and this is a. 9x square minus 9ax, right? 9ax, that is 3x. We can do like this. Let me write without factorization how to deal with question. It is also challenging question for me. A is 9, B is minus 9a plus b, and c is nothing else but 2a square plus 5ab plus 2b square. Now we have to calculate b. B is b square minus 4ac. That is here 81, because minus 9 whole square is 81. A plus b whole square, that is a square plus 2ab plus b square. Can I write like this? This means minus 9 times of a plus b whole square minus 4 into 9 into c means 2a square plus 5ab plus 2b square. So I have written here also, this is 81 minus 36, 9 4 is 36, and 2a square plus 5ab plus 2b square. What I can took maximum common out of these two? 9 can be taken common. So 9 I have taken common. 9 is left. Which 9 multiply in this one? So 9a square plus 18ab plus 9b square. If I have taken 9 common, then what is left there? 4. And that 4 will multiply inside. So minus 4 to ja 8a square. Minus 4 5 ja 20ab. And minus 4 2 ja 8b square, that will also come. Now 9a square minus 8a square is a square. 18ab minus 20ab is minus 2ab. 9b square minus 8b square is b square. And this is nothing else, a minus b whole square. And therefore, whenever we have to calculate under root d, it means what will come? Plus minus 3 times of a minus b. Now, suppose we want to find answer of the question. So, how to deal with such question? X is equal to minus b plus minus root under d by 2a. And what was b? B is minus of minus 9, that is plus 9, a plus b. B is nothing else but 3 times of a minus b divided by 2 into 9. A is 9. So first answer will be 9a plus 9b plus 3a minus 3b divided by 18. And second answer will be 9a plus 9b minus 3a plus 3b divided by 18. That is 9a plus 3a, 12a, 9b minus 3b, 6b by 18, and that will be 9a minus 3a, 6a plus 9b plus 3b, 12b divided by 18. So if I take 6 common, then that will be 2a plus b by 3, because 6 has been taken common and that cancels 18. And here also a plus 2b by 3, and that will be answer of this question. So solution set will be 2a plus b by 3 and a plus 2b by 3. These are the answer of the question. So hopefully you will be able to get it. Let me explain once again. If you see the big question, when I was a student, my teacher said, usually that whenever question looks very big, think about that solution is too small. When question looks very small, think solution is very difficult. Because big thing can be made small by cutting, pasting and rearranging. But a small thing can be big only if you have a creative mind. So when question looks very big, the solution would be small. When question is very small, you have to create the idea to make it bigger to solve it. So this is what the problem here. Here question looks big, but here a is 9, b is this, c is this, right? And we can calculate d, and after simplification, d comes a perfect square. So here I got the answer, and hopefully you understand it. So please share and subscribe our channel. Thank you very much for watching our videos. And for more, you can log on to our website www.arvindsingh.com. God bless you. Thank you.